Hey everybody, Johnny Baja here. Today I'm going to tell you the story about a black powder cannon that I built back in 1990. I built it for my brother on his 30th birthday. We had a huge surprise party up at the house for him, and we were into black powder cannons and all kinds of different things back in the day, and I figured I'd build the ultimate black powder cannon. So what we have here, stainless steel barrel. I've got it set up on a recoil. The shock down here is off my dad's old dune buggy. After he passed away, we sold his buggy and had some extra parts that we kept off of it. So I figured I'd put that shock on there, make it out of stainless so it lasts forever. And so what we have here, it's got a 15 and a half inch long internal bore with an inch and 7/8 diameter. And then the last couple of inches are bored out to 2.5 inches. And that's for putting tennis balls, balls, beer cans full of sand, whatever you want to put in there. And so this particular stainless steel, I found it at a scrapyard. It was just a solid piece of stainless. Didn't know what alloy, it wasn't marked. Sometimes you get the wrong alloy of stainless and you can't even hardly machine it. It's real miserable. So this particular metal turned out to be machinable, and it gave me all kinds of challenges. The lathe that I spun this on at our shop was not big enough to handle this heavy of weight or the length and what I was trying to do with it. I had to build all kinds of different extensions for my drills, boring bars. I had to hang the tail rest way off the end of the lathe, build adapters for that. Chattering was a big problem. As you're drilling or boring, chattering would be an issue. And then if it did chatter, you tried to clean up the chatter, you can only take little tiny cuts. The main barrel here, the taper on the barrel, everything's done by hand crank. So you might be able to go like 3 inches cranking on the taper. Then you'd have to reset everything, back it up, cut another 3 inches. And you know, that would be one cut going all the way down. Well, I can't even tell you how many cuts. I took a lot of cuts, cranking and cranking and cranking by hand. I did the bore first. I wanted to get that out of the way first, and then I spun the outside. What happened, I get that all done, I put it on its side on a milling machine to get the threaded holes in the side so where it's going to pivot at. And then everything you see in purple is all built out of steel, and it's all MIG welded together down there. The problem is when you put that much heat to steel, it's going to warp. I had a lot of bending on the plates, the uprights. I had a big twisted mess when I was done welding that all together. I had to use our forklifts, chains. I mean, we beat and pounded and heated things up. I did a lot of check straightening on that. Everything you see in purple except for these solid pieces on the upright there. It works real well. The way it works, you put your fuse here in the hole, you flip it up on its back, you put as much powder in there as you want, and you put a dry wad of like dry newspaper, pack that in real tight, use this ramrod right here, or you use a 4x4 and you beat on the end of this, and you pack that thing as tight as you can. Then you put a wet wad on top of that, pack that as tight as you can, wet wad, wet wad, wet wad, pack it tight. The tighter you pack it, the bigger the bang. So we were actually able to get 1 pound of powder in this thing at one time. We wanted to max it out and see what its abilities were. It banged so hard that it literally flipped the whole cannon upside down. And that was its limit, 1 pound at the time, back in those old red and white cans of black powder. It's quite entertaining. We've had it out quite a few times. It draws a crowd whenever you're getting ready to fire it. Even when it's just sitting still like this, people they're looking that thing all over, real interested in it. I was 27 years old when I built this, and quite a challenge. It's the hardest thing that I've ever machined. And I'm not talking about the hardness of the metal, I'm talking about the challenges that it created. I got about 40 hours in the barrel, 70 hours overall to build this, and quite the project. That's good, right there, dude.
Is that the last of it?
That's it.
Okay, now, where do we want to aim it?
Let's go out that way, just a little bit out.